Is this a license?
This was revealed today during the press conference organized by the National Drug Authority in Fort Portal City. Three people were arrested during the operation in Bundibugyo district.
Drug outlets that were operating without licenses or with unqualified personnel were closed, from where 140 boxes of assorted medicines worth 40 million Uganda shillings were impounded. This operation is in line with the NDA's mandate to protect and promote public health through effective regulation of human and animal medicines and health care products.
In May last year, the authority warned that it will start withdrawing the trading licenses of dealers and suspend production by local manufacturers implicated in falsified or substandard medicine deals. The authority said it had already suspended imports from three Chinese companies over the vice. However, there were questions on how fake drugs get into the market.
Outlined presser. And on average, we got 40 boxes from each district. And on average, we're seeing around 30 targeted outlets in our district. Now, these outlets have been mapped or earmarked by our teams in the field. During the year, we've been sensitizing, guiding and advising the operators to come and apply for licensing, but they've been adamant, and that's why we were left with the option to move in forcefully and try to enforce compliance.
According to Samuel Chomkama, the authority's head of enforcement, all operators who are working without licenses must hold all their operations until the licensing requirements are fulfilled.
NDA wants all operators who are still operating without license or supervising qualified personnel hold all their operations until the licensing requirements are fulfilled. We appeal to the public who always buy drugs on rent from pharmacies and drug shops. Remain vigilant and report anyone suspected to be involved in the drug crimes on our toll-free number 0800101999. I repeat.
However, despite the outcomes of the operation, Dr. Christopher Ruzindana, the authority's regional drug inspector, says that over the years, a reduction in the number of illegal drug outlets has been realized.
Over the years, we've seen a reduction in the number of illegal outlets across the region. This is because of these annual operations that we conduct that make it so difficult and expensive for one to operate an illegal outlet in the region, because the cost you pay is quite high and heavy. So yes, the challenge is reducing gradually, and I'm going to, appeal to those that plan to open up outlets to really work with us and we guide them so they can.
Story by Jonan Tusingire for the news.